Hello everybody, here a new video from Rene from Spain. And I want to make this video because 20 years ago it was 2001. And I want to show my favorite albums, my top 20 from 2001. Mi top 20 del 2001, no del 2021. Okay, this is 2001. The 2021, I will make it beginning of 2022. But this is my favorite album from 2001. 2001 was a great year, like you will see. You know, I have 20 incredible albums to show. These two albums also came out in 2001, but they didn't make my list. Axis, you know, German hard and heavy band, and Skull Fuel from the US. They released two albums before this one and one more after this one. And this was the third album, okay? A power US metal album. Quite a good one, to be honest. Talking about the US, also, this didn't make my list. Tampoco está en mi top 20. Nightshade. This was formed by Q5 band member or band members. Nightshade. They made one album in 91 and then this came out in 2001. This didn't make it either. Gravedigger. The Gravedigger. You know, it's a good album. Of course, I'm not saying it's not a good album, but the ones I'm going to show later, I like them more. Also, this is quite an underrated album by Aerosmith. You know, I like the ballad and the single Fly Away From Her. From Here was a very good song, to be honest. Yeah. Not a bad album at all. Also, this German power metal album didn't make it. Paragon with Steelbound. Check out Thunderstorm or Dead Squad. You know, you're quite influenced by the US power metal bands too from the 80s. And this one didn't make it either. Pinkrim 69, Endangered. That was the name of the album. Endangered, yes. I think I saw them on this tour or the tour before. I think it was a tour before with Bruce Dickinson. But anyway, now my top 20. Mi top 20. Desde lo que menos me gusta al que más me gusta. From my least favorite till my favorite. But they're all in my top 20. And I have a lot more albums from 2001. Because 2001 was a great year. For example, Steel Prophet. You know, also made a good album in 2001. And a lot more. But I just want to show this stuff. Okay. Number 20, we have Anvil with Plenty of Power. Anvil. What can I say about Anvil? A classic band from the 80s, of course. But they kept on making albums. Some better than others. And this was quite a good album. Check the song Ball of Fire. On number 19, we have Annihilator with Carnival Diablos. Again, a band that started in the late 80s and went on making albums every 2 years. You know, there always have been an album by Annihilator. And this has, of course, the title track. I really like the title track. I like also Time Bomb is a good song. Shallow Grave is a great song. Shallow Grave. I really like Shallow Grave because it has an AC/DC touch. On each of album, or practically on each album, they have one song that sounds very much like AC/DC. And then they have another song that sounds very much like Slayer. At least the riffings. You know, that's a typical thing that Annihilator does. Okay, please help me here. On number 18, we have Destruction with their second comeback album. You know, first they made one and later they made The Antichrist. And here we have, from the Eternal Devastation, we have Curse the Gods is on here. But it's a re-recorded song. And also we have The Exploited cover song. It's on here too. Yeah, maybe the most famous song is Nailed to the Cross. Of course, it's on here. Yes, Trust Still Dead. Yes, it's a good album. You know, it's not my favorite album by any means by this band. But it was quite okay album. I like the one after this one more, the Metal Discharge album. That was better in my opinion. On number 17 we have Jack Panzer. A great band that started again in like in the mid 90s. First they came with a bad album, but later they really get better with the next one. But it's a band from the 80s of course. But in the 90s and early 2000s they were quite strong, especially in Germany. You know, Ice Earth, Sabotage, and of course Jack Panzer. They were the three US bands doing very well in Europe and in Japan back in the late 90s. Even Manowar, you know, I could put them on that list, or Virgin Steel. Even Riot was still kicking some ass in Europe at least. You know, but like in America, everything was more fashion. You know, like everybody was, so not everybody, of course. You always had through metal people, but a lot of them start following, you know, fashions. Like, you know, like new metal came out and they start listening to that stuff. Because that's what they hear on the radio, in the magazines. But in Europe, the magazines like Rock Hard, Aardschok, GB Rock, you know, a lot of the magazines were still putting out interviews, you know, with heavy metal bands, power metal bands, also from the US, you know. Also when Twister Tower Dire came with a record. Actually in 2001 they released a record, but it's not on my list either. But the German magazines, like Heavy Oder Was, you know, for example, were making interviews. You know, they were interviewing them. Okay, sorry. A little bit itchy, my nose. Okay, good. The next one. On number 16, we have Megadeth. The World Needs a Hero. And this has songs like Motorcycle is a good song. Promises is a nice ballad. The Dread and the Fugitive Mind. It was already on a best of that came out before this release. But later they put that song on here too. Return to Hangar. Of course, like you know, Hangar 18 type of track, like a second part out, like kind of. And yes, good album, you know, I think underrated. Okay, on number 15, we have Saxon. Saxon from the UK, you know, like they always went on too. They started in the 80s, typical story, you know, that I already said about the older bands. And Saxon kept releasing good albums. The Court of the Crimson King is a cover song. Hell Freeze Over, Dragon's Lair, you know, good album. And then on number 14, I like to put two bands because they were starting around that time, maybe like a couple years earlier. But it was the first release by Witchburner, German thrash metal band. You know, they sounded very much like Sodom from the good 80s days. And this is a great album, Incantation of Evil. And also I want to talk about Urn. And this is more a thrash black metal band with some speed in it too. Great band too. You know, and around this time, Nocturnal Breeds, Bewitched, you know, they were Nocturnal. They were making great albums, you know, thrash metal, old school. Actually, in this top 20... the three biggest thrash metal bands from Germany are in here too. This is a spoiler. Okay, this is a spoiler. But anyway. On number 13, we have Ozzy Osbourne with Down to Earth. With two great ballads on here. Dreamer and Running Out of Time. Those are two great, great ballads. And check out Facing Hell. Great song too. On number 12, we have God Hate Us All. I mean, a lot of people stopped following Slayer, you know, after Divine Intervention, I think. You know, 94, I think the album came out, and a lot of people stopped following them. But, you know, they missed out on this album, because this is a very good album from 2001, of course. This came out, I think, on 11th of September 2001 or something like that. You know, when this happened in America. Disciple is a good song. Bloodline is a very good song. Check those two out. Okay, now some death metal. Ball Thrower with Honor, Valor and Pride. It's on number 11. check out the second track, Inside the Wire. Death metal, old school. You cannot go wrong with Bolt Thrower. Anything is good by them, in my opinion. But it was also a good album released back then. Okay, one of the I only showed Destruction. And now I'm showing Sodom, M16. Just now, a special edition came out of this release. Kind of extra songs. And also in a special box set with photos, bootlegs, bootleg recordings on vinyl, you know, M16. You know, the big hits on here are among the Weird Gong and Napalm in the Morning. But there's a lot of great songs on here. I like the other songs more than this two that I just named, to be honest. I sold them on this tour. Okay, Gamma Ray, number 9. No World Order, number 9, Gamma Ray. Another band that were still kicking ass during the 90s and 2000s. Before they started actually in 1990, I think. Healing for Tomorrow, I think, came out in 1990. I think so, yes. Could be 89 too. Of course, Kai Hansen, after Keeper of the Seven Keys Part 2, he left. And then soon after that, his first album came out. But here we have The Heart of the Unicorn, Heaven or Hell, Damn the Machine. Yeah. On number 8, we have Metal Lucifer. Great band from Japan, Heavy Metal Chainsaw. And this is a great homage to the new wave of British heavy metal. Mixed with some Japanese metal, especially because the lyrics are in Japanese. And it's just great. So many great songs on here. Heavy Metal Chainsaw, Flight of the Iron Pegasus, Warriors, Ride on the Chariots, Heavy Metal Samurai. Whoa, Heavy Metal Samurai is a great song. I remember in the pub back in 2001, 2002, we were always listening to this and we're singing the songs. You know, we love them. It's pure heavy metal. You know, this guy started in the late 90s and they always kept heavy metal alive, you know, during those days. Great. On number 7, we have a German band, Blizzard. And this, if you like Warfare, Bulldozer, mixed with Motorhead, you know, very dirty thrash metal, you know, it's really like, yeah, thrash metal, you will like this. No Beer Onto Metal, or Poser Crusher, Alcoholic Metal Mayhem, that's an anthem, you know, it's a great, great album, this really, really good album. And they have quite a few albums out, you know, Blizzard. I think the first single was with Witchburner. You know, I think it was the United Forces of Metal or something like that. It was a 7-inch single. And it was Blizzard with Witchburner, if I'm not mistaken. Witchburner for sure. But I think also Blizzard was on that single. I have to double check it. Of course, I have that one. You know, I have everything by these bands because I love them. Okay. Another, the biggest band from Germany. I mean, thrash metal band. Creator with Violent Revolution. Great album. Reconquering the Throne. Servant in Heaven. A King in Hell. Violent Revolution. I mean, you cannot go wrong with this album. It was kind of a comeback type of album. Because they you know, like they sounded more thrash metal. Even if the ones before, you know, they had some experimentations. But still, I don't dislike them at all. But this was for many people the comeback album. They you know, people that lost faith in Creator, they won it back, you know, thanks to this album. They won a lot of fans back. Violent Revolution. Now, number 5, we have a friends band, Condemned. And if you are into Sortilege or Blaspheme, you have to check this out if you don't know this band. This is pure 80s French metal with French lyrics. Malediction is the name of the band. It's amazing. It's just an amazing record. Les Fils de Satan. It's an amazing album. Okay. On number 4, we have Quiet Riot. A lot of people lost track on Quiet Riot many, many years before 2001. But this is a great record. The name of the record is Guilty Pleasures. And so many great songs on here. Feel the Pain, for example. Just check Feel the Pain. Let Me Be the One. I mean, this is a great, great record with the original or the most classic lineup of Quiet Riot on here. You know, it's like, it's amazing. It's a masterpiece. Frankie Benali, Rudy Sarso, Kevin DeBro, and Carlos Covazo. Actually, we saw them. They came to Spain, just to Europe to play in Spain. They played like 4 shows, and we saw them in Spain with the original lineup back in 2001, around that time. Okay. The next one is a Spanish band, the most famous Spanish speed metal band and the best speed metal band, one of the best speed metal bands ever, in my opinion. The late 80s stuff is amazing, the early 90s. But this is also a great album, Corazón de Metal de Muro. You know, I have a lot of good memories with this album, you know, seeing them live a couple of times. You know, Contra la Pared is a great song, Juez y Verdugo. Salemi, Puedo Vivir Sin Ti, you know, it's un discazo. Okay, it's a super, super record from 2001. And another Spanish one, on number 2, and again, a band important for us back then. This is my favorite album they ever released. They started already in the 90s, but this is my favorite album they ever did. And this is Enemigos de la Castidad. That's the name of the album. And the band is Lujuria. And of course, Oscar, the singer, you know, he has a peculiar voice, quite a rough voice. But if you like that voice, you will like this band because the music is also very, very good. Just check. No Soy Carne de Cañón. That's a great, great song. And Maria Martillo. That's another great song. You know, it's just those two songs. You should check them out. They're very, very, very good. Okay? Very good band. Very good band. You'll have quite a few strong albums. And the number one. What can it be? One of my favorite bands ever. They never stop. Or at least the leader. You know, of that band, always went on under this name. This was the last album with the original guitar player. Of course, he left during a part of the 90s, but then he came back, and then this was the last album he was on it till day. This band is still going on nowadays. And I'm talking about Wasp with Unholy Terror. This is a masterpiece, in my opinion. So many great songs. Let It Roar, great opening track. Locomotive Man is a great song. The title track is a great song. Wasted White Boys, you know, the last song is very good. It was a great album and an important album, you know, for all the metal people back then, 20 years ago. You know, very good. Okay. Guys and girls, I hope so you like this video. It's quite a long one, nearly 20 minutes. And this was my 2001. Maybe I can check some of the bands quickly that I saw in 2001, because I have here this book where I can see all the shows. Just to remind myself too, you know, some of the concerts I saw. Of course, I saw Saxon on the Killing Ground tour. That was 26th of October. You see it here. I also saw Judas Priest, actually, with Sabotage. You know, they also came to Spain. I saw Megadeth on the tour, on this tour that I talked about. You know, this The World Needs a Hero. And some other stuff. 2001 was a good year for metal, that's for sure. You know, and for my private life too, you know. It was a great, great year, 2001. Okay. Wait for my 2021 top 15, I think I'll make. Okay, stay metal, everybody.